it was at this moment he knew he would be an Iniquity intro. Bam, 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 bam. Yo, what's going on, guys? Hope everybody's having a good day. Welcome to the goddamn show. In today's show, we attempt to play smart. Now, I know what you're thinking. Iniquity, what are you doing? This is not you. I'm not exactly known for playing the way you're supposed to play, for playing with brains. You know what I mean? I just kind of hold forward, and sometimes it's at the expense of my digital video game life. And I'm willing to admit that, you know, I just have, we're gonna come back to this piece of fun by holding forward regardless of what I play. I'll play a North Star and still hold forward and get in your face, even though I know I'm probably gonna die. But in this game, something just switched and I was like, you know what? I got my Ronin. I want to play smart. I want to play Ronin the way I think he was designed to play. You know, some hit and run tactics. Get out of the situation if things don't look right. And normally I don't do that. I'm just like, F it. Whatever happens, happens. I'm just going to swing my sword, shoot my lead wall, maybe block every now and then. And if I die, I die. If he dies, he dies. But today I didn't do that. And I think it worked out pretty well. And you'll see that very, very soon. So if you couldn't already tell, this is not live commentary. This is some post-processed thoughts from your boy. And I must say, watching back my gameplay, I look good out there. That's Supernova camo, by the way. There's at least 10 people every video asking me what the camo is. So you have to go to the in-game store. You have to go to camo packs, go to Angel City pack, and the one camo I use is called Supernova. God, look at those moves! Woo! That was a really good start. I feel like I should Xbox record that. Do I not Xbox record that? I should have. Even though I'm recording for YouTube, regardless. I almost died there from the grenade. This is where we get into Roninya and shit hits the fan. I don't think I censored that right. I'm supposed to censor the... Every time I see a Spitfire main, I just want to their and... So I came back this way because I thought there was a pilot behind there. I realized he's here. And now I'm looking to score some core charge. So usually, not usually, but there are games where I just kind of ignore all the AI because I just want to go for pilot kills. This time around, I'm like, yo, if I see grunts, I'm going to kill some grunts because every single kill is 1% towards my core charge. And you never know, you might need that extra 20% when you come up against like a full health monarch or something. You know what I mean? So every single thing counts. Right now, I think there's a pilot here. I'm just waiting to see if he pops out, if he pokes. Nothing here. I'm like, where the hell did he go? I'm being very, very patient. I notice when I play smarter or when I attempt to play smarter, I don't hold forward as much. I just kind of wait an extra few seconds in situations I normally wouldn't because I'm thinking, hey, this guy might push me. That guy, I had no idea what he was doing. He just decided to run straight at me. Iniquity! And that's his prerogative. You know, that's his decision to die by the sword. So right now I'm looking for my enemies. I know my teammates are all over the place. And what I'm trying to do is, I thought I would mention this because I thought it was pretty interesting. I would never recommend running into this little cave or hut that this pilot just ran into. Maybe he thinks he's hiding and that no one had any clue that he was there, then okay, I understand. But if someone is aware of your presence in there, now you're backed yourself into a literal corner with no cover, nowhere to run, especially if you're going up against a Ronin that has a decent idea of what to do with his arc waves. I get a lot of people asking me, how do you send your arc waves up and above things? By the way, you can also do this with Scorch's flame wall, with his flame core, and if you learn how to do it, oh my god, it's so satisfying. Especially if people aren't aware or prepared, anticipating that you're going to arc wave them or flame core them when they're inside of a building and they think they have cover. It's so fun, especially when they think they're safe. So you want to learn how to do this. So what you want to do is stand right up against the platform you want to arc wave over and make sure you aim a little bit higher. If you don't do that, you're just going to arc wave the ground, and we're trying to avoid that right now. So again, stand right up against the item, aim a little bit higher, and then send out your arc wave. Practice this everywhere. There's so many different places on every single map you can do it. Once you practice it and you realize where you can do this, it's going to become second nature. You'll do it all the time. And I did it here because I thought, hey, if I hit this guy with the arc wave, it's going to stun him. We all know how annoying it is to get arc wave, energy siphoned, arc grenaded. And then that'll give me all the time in the world to aim my shot and wreck him. Pretty much third party all these fights. You know, sometimes I don't have really in-depth thoughts on those situations where the guy just stares at me hoping that I don't see him. If you don't move, the T-Rex won't see you. Well, things are different with Ronin. I saw that guy. It's the same concept here, though. Like, this map is... It's not the easiest map to kill pilots when you have a Titan out because of all this cover. However, I do like to stand on these stairs a lot because of the extra height that it gives you on both sides of the map. It's so useful, especially as a Ronin when you have that range with the lead wall. Pilots sometimes don't realize that you can get there and they think they're safe just running around that platform. There's a lot of spots like that on every single map. Imagine taking my battery. Excuse me, I got a little ahead of myself. I was gonna continue the video at this point, but I realized I should explain to you guys on video how to do that. because that is so much fun. If you can stop someone from taking your battery, take no damage at the same time, and get a free battery on top of it, I mean, who's better than you? Jaredude. Jaredude's better than you. That's the answer to the question. Jaredude's better than all of us. I love you, Dad. So what you want to do when you know a pilot is rodeoing you, you want to listen for the beep. Make sure you guys have your sound cranked way the hell up and listen for that beep. Did you hear that? I tried to, I guess, solo it for you. I don't know how loud I can make it for you guys. I normally record my gameplay at lower volumes, but trust me, in my headset, I hear this thing so goddamn loud, and I'm probably going blind.
Blind?
Of course, I meant to say deaf. You realize now I'm doing a commentary within a commentary within a commentary. I've lost track. I've lost complete... I don't know what this video is about anymore. But you want to wait for the beep, then you want to phase dash backwards, give it like, I don't know, half a second, and swing your sword upwards. It doesn't always work because, you know, pilots are, they're spontaneous. Sometimes they'll just jump forward, they'll panic and jump sideways, and you're not going to get the perfect timing. But 5 out of 10 times, dude, you keep practicing this, I promise you, you'll slice up that pilot, you'll get that battery right in front of you, just like a piece of candy, and they're just like, what the hell just happened? Because they thought they were going to get your battery run away and put it in their stupid Monarch. That gives you an advantageous position, especially with Ronin, that people have no idea of. And if it'll help you get an extra 2 or 3 kills per game, then I think it's worth it to take note of these things. I should probably do some more map guides and show you guys my little tricks. Now, I will admit, in this game, I started getting into the groove of killing pilots. If it was fun, it felt good. I was like, yo, they're all over this place. I'm just going to wait here. I didn't take notice that they have a goddamn Titan. And his name, say it with me, everybody, is Papa Scorch. And I knew that because I felt his hot ass oven mitten up against my cheeks. And the normal iniquity that you guys know would just be like, F it, I've got my sword core that you can clearly see here. I knew I had it. I'm going to swing my sword as hard as I can. I'm going to do so much damage. And even though I know he can do a lot of damage back to me, you know, he's got his flame shield. He might even have Inferno shield, his canisters, his firewall. Hell, he might have been up for a while and be close to his flame core. But in those situations, I'm like, F it, I've got my core. I'm going to kill him first. But also, I know I'm going to have like 1 bar of health left, or maybe even less than that when the fight is done. And I didn't want that this game. I wanted to try and play smarter. My thought process is maybe I can attack him from a different angle. Maybe I'll get lucky and flank him. Maybe by the time I re-enter the fight, my teammates will have shot their powerful AT weapons at this Scorch. And by the time I find him again, he'll have like half health instead of full. Or maybe I'll find him one shot because you guys did all the work, and then I could just come and steal the kill. Am I right, Ronin Mains? Moving on. I'm just giving myself a chance at changing the outcome of the fight. I think regardless, I knew I was going to win that fight. At least I went into it with that confidence. Now, it's not guaranteed, right? You might take an extra different approach to fight this Titan, and by the time you find him again, his teammates helped out in fighting you down with their AT weapons, or maybe somebody stole a battery or used the extra battery boost and gave that battery to that Scorch, and now he's more powerful. It's random. It's not always guaranteed, but I thought I would take that chance, and I had the confidence that we can come out on top. So because we made that decision to try and attack the fight from a different angle, or at least reset the fight, we ended up killing like 3 pilots in the process, right? That gives us 15 extra points, more core charge, and unfortunately, things didn't work out. We found this Scorch again, pretty much in the same position, and in my opinion, he still had the upper hand with his positioning. I didn't want to attack him head-on with my core because I thought the same thing as last time. He's going to end up dying, but I'm going to have like no health left when this is over. So I backed up again with the same explanation as last time. Now, things get a little hairy here. I look at the scoreboard and I see they have a bunch of Titans, and there's a Monarch back there looking straight at me. And Mama Monarch looks hungry, boys. And you know me, I'm Ronin Main. I'm afraid of Monarchs, but I have a core. So I said, you know what? We're going to ignore this Scorch completely because I think the Monarch is a bigger threat. No offense to any Scorch mains out there. Y'all are dope. But I don't want Monarch to get any upgrades because we all know how deadly that can be. So I'm like, you know what? F all that safe play. I'm going to take as much damage as I need to, and we need to destroy this Monarch ASAP. We have the core to do it. We got lucky here. For some reason, she thought we still went on that left lane, or her perspective on the right lane, and we caught her off guard here. We got a few extra swings in with our core, and things went rather nicely, in my opinion. Until they didn't, because at the corner of my eye, I see that Tone coming for me. She's probably full health. I just finished my core up. I'm half health now. I'm like, let me reset the fight with the same explanation as last time. Who knows? This tone might be terrible. I might be on my A game this match and kick her ass, but you never know. This could also be the best tone in the world, and I don't want to give her that advantage. I want to last as long as possible in this one Titan, and I want to try and make the best decisions to do so. So again, I reset the fight. I phase dash the hell out of there, and what do we find? Another enemy Titan. This time, it's a North Star, but she doesn't know that we were there. I thought maybe I can catch her off guard, hit her with an arc wave, do some nice burst damage, and then get the hell out of there because I know it's going to be a 1v2 Titan fight, and that's probably not a good idea. So now I'm looking at the scoreboard. They have three Titans. We have two. Three of my teammates haven't dropped yet. I see this pilot here. I give him a second. Maybe he'll poke. He won't. He just runs away. And I notice they're all back there. So I'm like, hey, all my teammates are back here. I'm going to finally play around my teammates. I'm not baiting them or anything. I just think it's better right now because they have more health. They just spawned their Titans recently. I should play around them. So that Tone is still full health. I want to get some cover. And this is where I stop to think, wait a second. There's a Tone to my right. Those Titans are all the way in the back left. Let me try and flank them. At least let me try and get a different angle on somebody. Maybe we'll get a successful flank and hit somebody with our arc wave and do some burst damage. But then I see this Tone. So right now I'm thinking, let me actually just listen for footsteps. Where is she attacking me from? I think I hear her to my left, so I'm gonna try and hit her with an arc wave and then get the hell out of there, build some core. She probably knows I'm very weak now though, so she's gonna get aggressive, right? Yeah, she does. So I'm like, okay, my teammates are still over here to my right. This is probably common knowledge, but just in case, you can see I phase dash towards my teammates here, not only to get closer to them or extend the distance between myself and that Tone, but I knew she was locked on with her tracking rockets. Pay attention whenever you're fighting Tones to the bottom middle of your screen. The game actually tells you like, hey, this Tone just shot you three times and now she's ready to shoot her rockets at you. That's when you usually want to save your phase dash unless you just can't avoid it. But this will help you in the fight because it takes away Tone's main damage output option. You know, if you can always avoid her tracking rockets, you're in for a good time. Let me try and kite her over so I have some help. We end up finding the Scorch here. I don't think we actually do any damage. Okay, we got some extra hits in just because we were trying to run away from somebody else. Now, I know this Tone is now probably occupied with my teammates that I led her into. And you best believe I'm staring at my minimap right now, trying to find exactly where she is. So because of that one decision we made to back up and force her into my teammates, we now have free reign to flank this Tone in the booty, and it always feels good. Watch Tone die. Now, she's still occupied with my teammate, has no idea that I'm right here with my Arc Wave primed, ready to steal that goddamn kill, and it feels so good. I love this game. I love talking about my decisions, and the point I'm just trying to make here is, man, every single decision is so crucial. You might make one decision that you think is perfect, and then when you turn around, it ended up being the worst thing, and you get bum rushed by six enemy Titans. Or you could have something like this game, where because in the very beginning we avoided or reset a fight with that one Scorch, we ended up surviving the entire match and getting a bunch of Titan kills. And this doesn't only go for Ronin. Obviously, I'm a Ronin Monarch. Get the hell out of my way! Main, so most of my knowledge is gonna come from playing him, but you can and should do this with every single Titan. There are so many games I'll solo queue into attrition, and you know that moment where there's like six Titans out on the field, it feels like a Titan Brawl match all of a sudden. That fight is the most crucial, because if you can get Titan control in attrition, in my opinion, that is the most important way to win. And there are so many times where I'll see all of our Titans pretty much protecting the same lane, or they become complacent in that original position. They feel safe, right? Because they're with their teammates and they're like, well, if my teammates are here and we're all camping together, we should be all right. No, I want you guys. Did he quit the game? We were just getting started. Okay. Guys, to be that wild card, Purple Army. God damn it. Go out there, take the extra effort, go for those flank routes, think a little bit more about your positioning, and I promise you'll win more games. I'm not trying to tell you that I know everything. I'm not a perfect player, man. I win games and I lose games. I'm just like you guys, but I feel like if I make a good decision, if I have a good game, I should showcase that and what the hell's he doing? Try and explain my thought process to try and improve anyone's game out there that's actively trying to get better. That's the goal here, man, and I hope somebody somewhere learn something from that. Regardless, thank you guys for listening to me ramble. Thank you for being here. You have no idea how much it means to me. I love this community with all my heart, and it's still growing, man, almost 3 years later. Thank you for allowing me to do something I love. If you couldn't already tell, the enemy team started quitting out after we won that big Titan fight, and we'd survived the whole goddamn time with that one chassis with just a little bit more thinking than normal. Now I'm gonna go back to my stupid play and just hold forward. I'll see you guys next time. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you drop a like for me. If you're brand new here, click that subscribe button, trigger that notification bell. I love you. Peace.